if you were to talk to somebody right now in the USL front office, which I haven't, and again, this is all just based on experience, I'll bet you there's people there going, you know, we have to look at that as an option, that when they come in, and well, it might just be the right thing to do to save our asses and keep everybody from going belly up.
You know, but what's interesting is, you know, this MLS Next Pro, that hasn't been a secret. I mean, we knew it was coming. We knew that teams were leaving USL Championship and USL League One that were MLS affiliated, that were going to this new league. So it's not a secret, or it didn't catch anybody by surprise. What I think USL is going to do next is they're going to announce promotion and relegation. And I think that is going to be their image of difference. And I think that is going to be what they're going to try to hang their hat on, and what they're going to try to make the reason why people should watch them instead of MLS, or including MLS. But I think you're going to see promotion and relegation out of USL before you see a merger.
They're going to have to, though, do an amazing job marketing, and they're going to need stars. Because let's face it, MLS has the top players. USL's got to come in, and they've got to promote the daylights out of these teams. They got to make sure that people are showing up in the stands, watching on pay-per-view, watching on YouTube, wherever, getting their players out there. Because again, I'm going to go back to the old NBA ABA. It's what the ABA did between Julius Erving, George Gervin, and so many great players who were their stars. They got to be so big that the NBA said, you know, those are great markets. The Virginia market, but here's New the Jersey, difference. We got to grab that. And that's what saved everybody. And the ABA went right to it because they knew they couldn't exist long-term as a full-time league. They knew this. I think.
But there is a difference. There is a difference. USL has never pretended that they wanted to go head-to-head, either in signing players or in the competition than MLS. So that's a big difference than, say, the, you know, NASL, you know, 2.0, where they said, we want to be the top division and we want to go head-to-head with MLS. So I think that's a big difference there. I think that they are going to implement promotion and relegation. They already have great television systems set up where the games are all on ESPN+. They're on locally in a number of markets. I think that they have the right idea. I think they're going to go pro rel. MLS is not set up for pro rel. I think what it will set up is a showdown between the original U.S. model of professional sports, which is generally what MLS has right now, two divisions in a playoff. And I think that you're going to see pro rel in USL. We're going to see that for a number of years, and we're going to find out what fans think is a better way to play the game. And I think that is what fans in the United States are going to get out of all of this.
I'll give you that. But at the end of the day, it still comes down to dollars and cents. If the sponsors aren't there to promote USL and are not there, if the ratings aren't there, if the TV dollars aren't there, and they start to bleed and they start to hemorrhage that money, and everybody right now is scrambling one way or another, even though some of the sports have really unlimited cash. The NFL, the NBA, college football, to many ways, they all have unlimited dollars. I mean, they can do whatever they want. USL's not at that stage. They're still sort of like, boy, I don't want to upset anybody here, because the quality of play is outstanding, but they are still.
Yeah, it really is. What I think is the difference is in USL, nobody's pretending to be the major league. They're not out spending an incredible amount of money.
No, but they want to be the major league. They still need to compete for the dollars. That's my whole point. If Nabisco is out there.
But they have built, over the last 4 or 5 years, USL has continued to get stronger. They've added more and more cities. They've added more and more leagues. They have their own academies now. They're just doing it on a smaller scale.
They've done a great job. I'm not taking anything away from them. It's a great job.
I think right now, you're going to see USL kind of reorganize a little bit after they lose all of these MLS-related teams. The league is going to get a little bit smaller, but then it will get a little bit larger because they'll go back to expanding to other cities.
Good.
I say this. Give it 5 years. Come back to me in 2027, and let's see where these two systems are. I believe that they will be independent of each other, and I think that there are going to be fans that will really gravitate towards USL with promotion and relegation, because remember, different than the way we grew up, where we never saw EPL games, we never saw Bundesliga, we never saw La Liga, we never saw Serie A. We didn't see all those things growing up because, look, let's face it, we barely had cable growing up. So now that you can watch all of these, now that you can watch all of these different leagues from around the country anytime you want, you can watch the Mexican league, you know, almost every night on, you know, Unimas and Univision and TuneIn and everything else.
It's all wonderful. It's all wonderful. There's a lot of soccer out there, but my point still comes down
promotion
to this.
And relegation. Promotion and relegation is very, very popular with American fans because they watch what's going on with the EPL and Bundesliga 1 and 2 and Serie A and Serie B and La Liga and everything else. I really think give USL 5 years of promotion and relegation, and I think that you are going to see them grow even greater. I think that they can keep it at their minor league level in terms of budget.
Okay.
I think that you are just going to see a tremendous amount of soccer in the United States. I think you may, going back to our previous conversation, you may start to see some USL players playing for the U.S. men's national team, because you already have USL players playing for other national teams.
Okay.
That was something that was very big with the NASL 2.0. There were players that played for national teams, including the U.S. men's national team out of that second division. But I really believe that unless USL really stumbles and stubs their toe, they have an opportunity at a lower budget to be on a popularity standpoint. They potentially, with promotion and relegation, can be as popular as MLS.
And unfortunately, I'm going to counter that by saying, yes, you're right. You're absolutely the 5 years, I think it's a great idea. And I want them to survive. I don't want anybody to go out of business. I want everybody to make $1 million and retire to a small island somewhere in the South Pacific. Like is my plan if anybody wants to give me the money if you win.
I don't need the South Pacific. I'll take the Caribbean on that.
I'll take it. It's easy. But here's the deal. And I'll go back to what I said earlier. If a sponsor, and I'm going to use Nabisco, comes in and they have a $10 million a year soccer budget, because of COVID-19, because of supply side issues, because of the economy, not only in America, but around the world as well, and the economy starts to falter, and that budget goes from $10 million to $6 million, somebody's going to have to suffer. And in the end, the marketing and salespeople are going to look at, I've got MLS over here, I've got USL over here, I got bigger markets here, I got bigger ratings, that's where my money is going. And God forbid USL, if that happens, then you're going to have owners that are going to start to abdicate, you're going to have salaries are going to go down, you're going to have interest that will wane. I hate to say it, but I've seen this happen before far too many times. I hope the USL has the wherewithal to outlive that and to withstand it. But in today's economy, in today's world, I'm not so sure.